Hey, trans youth. I don't really have anything to talk about other than the topic today, so I'm just going to jump right into it. The topic for today is whether or not I really care about passing and how much. I can tackle this two ways. Personally, just myself, my own opinions, or I can include my environment, and I'll get to that one later. But personally, I really don't care. I really don't. I can be walking down the street and I could care less who clocks me. I really could. If they give me that weird look, then that's fine. I don't care. Because I am living my own life, and my life has improved tenfold since I started my transition. And I love my life. I am happy. I'm content. And I'm being active, 10 or 20 times more active than I was as a guy. I'm not depressed, and I'm not delusional anymore or anything like that, so I'm fine. As a girl, I am happy, I'm content, we're good. However, I live in Wyoming, highly conservative state, like, I think it was 40% of our population or more is over the age of 60. We're highly conservative, very Republican, and that does not bode well for a transsexual, transgender of any form, actually. So, while I live in pretty much the best town in the state for myself, I do have to watch out. There are basically two ways to survive as a trans person here. There is fighting it, because there's going to be a lot of flack, and there's fighting it. There's, hey, here's what I am, deal with it, and if you want to fight me, I'll fight back. Or there's pass to the point where no one knows, so you don't get any flack, and you can still go around. Now, considering my girth, I don't think I want to fight, honestly, because I'm weak, very weak. So, really, the only option for me while living in the state is to make sure I pass as well as possible, which kind of makes it more important for me. If I were in like Colorado or anything like that, I could really care less because they're not as ruthless about it. But here in Wyoming, I catch a lot of flack if someone knows. Not from like the younger generation or anything like that. In my experience, the younger generation is totally fine with it. But I'll catch that 60-year-old man who's like, "You're such a pretty girl." And then as soon as he finds out, he A, wants nothing to do with me. B decides he's going to give me a gigantic Christian lecture, or C actually tries to force me not to be me. So, in order to stay away from that, I found that passing becomes important given my environment in the state. That being said, I'm probably going to move south to Colorado sometime within the next year or two. Because they're a lot more lenient around there, and I really like them a lot more. Colorado is a lot more progressive than Wyoming is, for sure. Wyoming is always a last to change state. We were the last to do one thing, the last to do the next, and the only reason we take initiative pretty much ever is for the good of the state. Like, in order for us to become a state, we were the first state to give rights to women. But that was to become a state. That wasn't, hey, we believe in rights for women. That was, we need more numbers. We need a larger population to become a state, so let's include the women. Otherwise, we are always the last to change. Which is really annoying, and and I really kind of want to get out of here. So, yeah, passing is important if I don't want to get beat up later on. But if that whole element of getting beat up or taking flak or anything like that is gone, I could really care less if someone knows I have a penis. I really could. Like, all of my friends are younger generation and none of them care. All of their friends, none of them care. Some of them actually think it's pretty cool. And the older generation is not happy with me. That's pretty much all I have to say on the subject. So yeah. Otherwise, if you have any other questions, send them to transyouthchannel@gmail.com. If you're going to send it via YouTube, we do get an email notification, but chances are an alternative question will be picked. So just send a straight question to transyouthchannel@gmail.com, and who knows, you might get your question answered by a ton of awesome people. So that's definitely worth it. And also, down in the description bar of every video that I do, I also do this on my personal channel, there is a survey. The survey is basically just for a giant map to actually decide once and for all and solve the question, where is the best place to live if you're trans? Basically, you fill out the survey, make sure you give me numbers, otherwise I can't quantify it and toss it onto the map. It's a giant initiative and you should do it because it would definitely help me out. It would definitely help you out, your trans community out, and the country out. So, I really hope you guys do it. I really need the points. And it's a really quick survey. It's only 5 questions. It shouldn't really be too hard. It's based upon personal opinion of your own place. And by all means, if you've lived several places, you can fill it out multiple times. So leave it in the comments if you don't want to put descriptions, or personally send me a message if you want to give me details, which I am totally okay with. I love details. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I will see you next Sunday on Trans Youth, and if you watch my personal channel, on Wednesday for a voice lesson and on Friday for a normal video. Otherwise, tune in to Trans Youth Channel every day for one new video on one new opinion on one opinion throughout the week. There's plenty of us here, so I'm pretty sure we'll get a video up every day. So yeah, that's it. I will see you guys next Sunday, okay? Love you. Bye.